إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليماً كثيراً. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالاً كثيراً ونساءً، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أعاذنا الله وإياكم وجميع المسلمين من البدع والضلالات والنار، آمين. All the praises for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. We praise Him, seek His assistance and beseech Him for His forgiveness. We seek refuge with Allah from the evils of our own souls and from the evils of our actions. Indeed, whosoever Allah Most High guides, there is no one that can lead him astray. And whosoever Allah Most High sends astray, then there is no one that can guide him. I testify that there is none worthy of worship except Allah alone without any partner. And I testify that our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the slave and messenger of Allah. We ask Allah to bestow His choicest salutations, peace and blessings on our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family and companions. O you who believe, fear Allah as you ought to be feared, and do not die except in a state of submission to Allah as Muslims. O people, fear your Lord who created you from a single being, and from him created his spouse, and from the two of them brought forth men and women in abundance. Fear Allah through whom you ask your rights, and keep the family ties, and indeed Allah is ever watchful over you. O you who believe, fear Allah and speak a word that is true and just. Allah will rectify for you your deeds and forgive you your sins. And whosoever obeys Allah and His Messenger has attained the ultimate success. Indeed, the truest of speech is the speech of Allah Most High. And the best of guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the worst of affairs are novelties in the religion. And every such novelty is a heresy, a bid'ah. And every bid'ah is misguidance, and every misguidance is in the fire. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us and all the Muslims from the innovations, the misguidance, and the fire. Ameen. Ibadallah, inna ayyam al-hajj qad inqadat, wa raja'u wufuda ibad al-Rahman wa duyuf al-Rahman ila biladihim. ونهنئهم بما حصلوا عليه من المغفرة والرحمة والأجور العظيمة الكثيرة بحمد الله تبارك وتعالى. وسيد الله سبحانه وتعالى, the days of Hajj is past, and the delegations of the slaves of the Most Merciful and the guests of the Most Merciful, they have returned to their homelands. And we congratulate them for what they have attained of the forgiveness and mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and for what they have attained of the great bounties and rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَنُذَكِّرُ أَنفُسَنَا وَإِيَّاهُمْ, and we remind ourselves and them that this Hajj that they undertook, هذه الرحلة العظيمة الإيمانية, ليس كأي رحلة, that this journey they undertook to the Hajj This journey of Iman and Taqwa is not like any other journey. And it is not like any other travel. بَلْ بِهَا تَبْدَأُ حَيَاةٌ جَدِيدَةٌ Rather with it a new life starts. This journey of Hajj and the person's fulfillment of his manasik and his return, a new life starts for him. And this life is not the life of a laqab and the life of a new appearance. It's not a new nickname, Ya Hajji, and a new appearance that now he can wear the jubba and the shimar on the days of Eid. No, it is a new life of Iman and Taqwa. A life wherein he strives to be thankful to Allah for the ni'mah that Allah has bestowed upon him. That ni'mah that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned to us. That man hajja wa lam yarfuth wa lam yafsuq raja'aka yawm waladathu ummuh. That he who made the hajj and was not illicit in deeds in any way and was not sinful, then he will return like the day his mother gave birth to him. Hani'an lahum. Congratulations to them. Subhanallah, who have returned from the journey of Hajj, wherein they fulfill the obligations and stayed away from Arafah, wal fusuq, wal jidal. They stayed away from illicitness and from sinfulness and from argumentation and quarreling. And they came back from that Hajj like the day their mother gave birth to them. Hani'an lahum, Allahu Akbar. They come back forgiven of all sins. They come back with a clean slate that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made like the day that they came into this world. Subhanallah. We rejoice for them. And we remind them that of being grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to uphold His ni'am upon you. Is to uphold His favors upon you. That like He has granted you that forgiveness, and He has granted you that expiation of sins, and He has granted you that darajat and hasanat and ujur that you received during those manasik of Hajj, it is upon you to uphold it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He does not look merely at the fact that you have traveled. He does not look merely at the fact that you have witnessed the places and the sites of the manasik. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks at what your heart has attained. What your heart has attained, and this is why Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhumah, that when he witnessed the Hajj with his father, Amir al-Mu'mineen Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and when Umar radiallahu anhu stood at Safa, he looked at the multitudes of people whilst he was standing on the hill. He looked at the multitudes of people that have come for the Hajj. And Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he looked and he was amazed at the amount of people that was gathered. And you can imagine, ayyuha al-ikhwa, the comparison between those gathered those days and those who gather today. Oh, subhanallah. Abdullah ibn Umar, out of amazement, he says to his father, Ya abati, ma akthar al-haj al-am. He says, oh my father, how many are the hujjaj this year? فقال عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه. So عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه, he said, يا بني الركب كثير. الركب كثير والحاج قليل. He said, oh my son, the travelers are many. The travelers are many, but those who are making Hajj, they are few. Subhanallah. That what Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu was referring to is that many are those who travel to the Hajj, many are those who make their way there and stand at the places of the manasik and the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, But those who are making the Hajj with their hearts and with their souls, they offer you. This is what Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu alluded to. So we say to those who have returned from Hajj that to show to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that indeed you went upon this Hajj with the zad that Allah commanded. The zad that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded. And this is the zad which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. He mentions the Hajj in Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala says, فَمَنْ فَرَضَ فِيهِنَّ الْحَجَّ فَلَا رَفَثَ وَلَا فُسُوقَ وَلَا جِدَالَ فِي الْحَجِّ وَمَا تَفْعَلُوا مِنْ خَيْرٍ يَعْلَمُهُ اللَّهُ وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, whoever embarks upon Hajj, in the months of Hajj, فَلَا رَفَثَ وَلَا فُسُوقَ وَلَا جِدَالَ فِي الْحَجِّ. Then there's no illicitness, there is no sinfulness, and there is no quarreling and argumentation during the Hajj. And whatever you do of good, Allah knows it and make provisions. But indeed, the best provision is taqwa. Indeed, the best provision is taqwa Allah Azza wa Jal. That you have gone to that Hajj with fear of Allah Ta'ala in your heart, with consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your heart, and you have maintained it upon that Hajj. And so when you return, then you will continue with it. Like you went ayyuha al-Hajj, and you were very conscious about the statement of Allah, وَلَا رَفَثَ فَلَا رَفَثَ وَلَا فُسُوقَ وَلَا جِدَالَ فِي الْحَجِّ. There's no illicitness, no relations of genders. Like this, you will remember when you return from Hajj, there is no illicitness. That as a Muslim, as a believer, as one who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven all his sins, you should stay free from this. وَلَا فُسُوقَ, no fisk, clear disobedience to Allah, transgressing the boundaries of Allah, disobeying the commands of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. وَلَا فُسُوقَ, there is no fusuq. Like on Hajj there was no fusuq, when you return from Hajj there should be no fusuq. وَلَا جِدَالَ, and no quarreling and argumentation. That as you maintain this in Hajj, when you return from Hajj, يعني you have a better character. That you are not quarrelsome and argumentative and fight for everything. No, because you know that whatever you withhold from of these actions, it is good before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whatever good you do in addition to it, it is good to Allah ta'ala. وَمَا تَفْعَلُوا مِنْ خَيْرٍ يَعْلَمْهُ اللَّهُ. And whatever good you do, Allah knows it. Whatever good you do, Allah knows it. And you went with the provision of taqwa. And you have to maintain يعني that degree of taqwa. You have to maintain that degree of taqwa. You have to be better after Hajj than you were before Hajj. You have to be more conscious of the Hajj than you were before Hajj. Like you walked ayyuha al-Hajj, and like you traversed and traveled from these places, and like you went and marched to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to do your manasik, to do your tawaf, which is salah, and to pray behind the maqam, your salah. Like this, you need to maintain walking to the house of Allah. You need to maintain walking to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah, or going to the house of Allah by whatever means you go. How often is it that you hear the person doesn't attend the masjid, the person doesn't pray, the person commits illicitness, the person is guilty of fusuq, the person has bad character, and they say, huh, what is a haji? This is common. Subhanallah, it must not be like that, ayyuhu al-hajj. It must not be like that, oh you, man hajja bayt Allah al-haram, you may hajj to the house of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, every day, five times a day, you have the opportunity to go to the house of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. To go to the house of Allah and be forgiven and have your sins expiated with every step. And be raised a daraja with every step. And be granted a good deed with every step. So as you have gone and traveled far to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you need to travel every day to the house of Allah for your salah. Go to the masjid when it is the waqt of salah, like you were of the millions who went to the house of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala in Ummul Qura. Be of the millions who go to the house of Allah every dhuhr and every asr and every maghrib and every isha and every fajr. Be of the millions of Muslims who go to the house of Allah and pray their salah in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you have returned from Hajj, Allah, you need to maintain this. You need to maintain this. This is from taqwa Allah azza wa jal. And this was the provision that you took with you to the Hajj. And this is what you attain when making Hajj to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not a mere journey that you have traveled to and gone sightseeing and shopping and come back to tell the people where you've been. You come back to show the people how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through His deen guides you, through His deen makes you firm upon His obedience, through His deen brings you back to istiqamah, to steadfastness upon the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept the hajj of all those who make hajj to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make them better after hajj than they were even before they went to hajj. And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant all of the Muslims and all of us to make hajj to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول ما سمعتم وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين والجنة للموحدين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله إله الأولين والآخرين. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين. صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. عباد الله، إذا تأملنا سورة الحج، we consider Surah Al-Hajj. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when beginning the Surah of Hajj, did not begin with mentioning the manasik of Hajj. He did not begin with mentioning Mina or Muzdalifah or Arafah. In fact, He doesn't mention it. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts Surah Al-Hajj with a reminder to all of mankind. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم. O people, fear your Lord. O people, fear your Lord. Indeed, the tremor of the final hour is an immense thing. The tremor of Qiyamah, the earthquake of the final hour is an immense thing. Allah Ta'ala reminds us in the beginning of Surah Al-Hajj to be reminded that when we stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on Arafah, gathered with all those millions of Muslims, that we remember, that we reflect that this is how we will stand before Allah yawm al-qiyamah. That we will stand before Allah and hisab will be taken with us. Allah will judge us and take reckoning of us as we gather in front of Him. So begin Surah Al-Hajj, reminding us, O mankind, O people, fear your Lord, for verily the shaking and the tremor of the final hour is an immense thing. تذل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. The day that you see it, every breastfeeding mother will run away from what it is feeding. Every breastfeeding mother will neglect and leave that child, that infant, that baby. Every woman who is pregnant and every female that is pregnant will immediately abort the pregnancy. You will see people walking around in a drunken stupor. That people who are drunk, وَمَا هُمْ بِسُكَارَى, that they are not drunk. وَلَكِنَّ عَذَابَ اللَّهِ شَدِيدٌ. However, the punishment of Allah is severe. The punishment of Allah is severe. Allah reminds us that when we speak about Hajj and we are going to Hajj and we read Surah Al-Hajj, that it is about repenting to Allah. It is about making Hajj with your heart to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Affirming and establishing taqwa of Allah. Fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fearing the day that we will stand before Him in Hisab. The day that He will take reckoning with us and look at our records. It is about taqwa Allah azza wa jal. Therefore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, even when mentioning the hadith in Surah Al-Hajj, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَنْ يَنَالَ اللَّهَ لُحُومُهَا وَلَا دِمَاءُهَا. Its flesh does not reach Allah. Its blood does not reach Allah. وَلَكِنْ يَنَالُهُ التَّقْوَى مِنْكُمْ. But the taqwa from you reaches Allah. The taqwa from you reaches Allah. That fear of Allah, that consciousness of Allah, that ikhlas to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what is important to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what is important. This deen is not a deen of empty manasik. This deen is not a deen of empty rituals. This deen is not a deen of empty practices. Every practice in this deen is to rectify our hearts and our souls for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And likewise, when you have gone to Hajj, you have rectified your heart and your soul to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you come from Hajj, you maintain it. You maintain it. كَذَلِكَ سَخَّرَهَا لَكُمْ. Like this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made subservient to this, or to you, these animals, yani that you sacrifice it. Yet the flesh does not reach Allah. Yet the blood does not reach Allah. But the taqwa from you reaches Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the hadith in Bukhari and Muslim, he gave glad tidings to all those who make Hajj to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we convey those glad tidings to them, and we encourage those who have not gone to go to attain this great virtue. To attain this great virtue of making Hajj to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the words of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَالْحَجُّ الْمَبْرُورُ لَيْسَ لَهُ جَزَاءٌ إِلَّا الْجَنَّةِ. And the Hajj al-Mabrur, the Hajj that was done with bir, with righteousness, with goodness, there is no reward for it except the Jannah. There is no reward for it except the Jannah. If the Hajji has gone and he has made his Hajj upon righteousness and upon taqwa Allah Azza wa Jal, and he maintains that after Hajj, wallahi this Hajj, it will be a means for him to enter into Jannah, and there's no reward for it except the Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it from them, and may Allah grant those of us who never went to go to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to perform the Hajj to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. اللهم لا تدع لنا في جمعنا هذا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا دينا إلا قضيته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا حقا إلا أعليته ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا والآخرة إلا أعنتنا على قضائها ويسرتها لنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين وأهلك الكفرة والمشركين يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر المسلمين المستضعفين في فلسطين. اللهم انصر المسلمين المستضعفين في فلسطين. اللهم انصر المسلمين المستضعفين في فلسطين وفي الصين وفي كل مكان يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصرهم وعجل بنصرهم يا قوي يا عزيز. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على نبينا وحبيبنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. والحمد لله رب العالمين.